Good morning to all of you, and I am M.G. Prasad, mathematics lecturer in Vijaya Chetana College. Okay, and first time we have not seen each other because of COVID. You know, you are taking online classes, and I am also teaching an online. So let us see. Let us pray God as quickly as possible. Let us meet. Okay, now I am M.G. Prasad, mathematics lecturer here, and for many years I have worked in different colleges in Bangalore, in other places also I worked. Now I am in Vijaya Chetana. I am M.G. Prasad. You can call me M.G.P. sir. You can call me M.G.P. sir. Don't make it as M.G.R. Don't make this one like this. You know what is M.G.R.? You know that M.G.R. was a great chief minister of Tamil Nadu, and he was a great actor also. So don't put a line like this. You call me only MGP sir. MGP means Madhav Rao Guru Prasad. Okay, that is the initial. MGP sir, you can call me. As I said, I got some 40 years of experience for you, and you are very lucky to have a teacher like me. And there are two teachers for mathematics for you. I also take, and Mr. Revanna also will take. So two teachers for mathematics for you. One is Revanna, and he will take some portions, and I will also take little portions of first year PUC. Okay, and I am concentrating first on trigonometry. Before I take up, I will tell you a few tips about mathematics. Mathematics is a very interesting subject and a very, very useful subject. So mathematics, where you can use your maximum brain. Use mathematics, because in other subjects you use brain, but still that usage is limited. But here, where you have to apply your mind, that is the beauty of mathematics. And mathematics means you have to use your intelligence and brain also. And your brain gets sharpened in mathematics subjects. So I always read mathematics. All other subjects are also very good, very nice, very good subjects, and where you have to use brain, but here usage of brain is more. That is why I said you mathematics, and there are so many proverbs on mathematics. There are so many proverbs in mathematics. A person who is good at mathematics is always can lead a happy life. He is humorous also, and he can lead a very happy life. So be good at mathematics, and a man who is good at mathematics automatically is good at all other subjects. So there is another proverb: a man who is good at mathematics is always good at all other subjects also. Apart from it, a person who knows mathematics and English well, they can manage anywhere in the world. So there is another proverb: a person who is good at mathematics and English can manage. You live in, whether it is in Zambia, whether it is in Japan, whether it is in Korea, anywhere he can survive and come. So mathematics, one should know always beautiful mathematics. And I also write small chutkas. We should note that I also like literature, and I write small chutkas in Kannada. Okay, in that one chutka on Ganita. Okay, Ganita, Indu Arithirabeku Ganita, Adakkuntu Akarshaka Seleta. Indu Arithirabeku Ganita, Adakkuntu Akarshaka Seleta. Baruvudu Adannu Maduta, Baradiddalli Adu Talekereta. Baruvudu Adannu Maduta, Baradiddalli Adu Talekereta. Nimiga Talekereta Agbaru. You should practice, nimge barabeku. What is the important thing in mathematics is practice, 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 practice well. Practice is the mantra in mathematics, where you can definitely become master over mathematics. Once you are master over mathematics, you will be the happiest man. Other subjects will automatically come to you. Okay? Mathematics is something like playing against Australia team. India team or any team playing against Australia cricket team. You know, Australia team is always tough team. Like that, mathematics is also like tough. But once you start beating, that means once you start winning the matches against Australia, that means you are beating mathematics. So see, try to practice well and become master over mathematics, and that will be very helpful for you for other subjects also. Your science subjects is full of mathematics only. Physics is mathematics. Your chemistry, physical chemistry, is also mathematics. We use mathematics even in biology, the counting of chromosomes and all. Again, there also mathematics comes. So you should be very good at mathematics. Okay, this is, you have to practice, practice, practice. There are two options in mathematics. Either if the problem is correct, you will get full marks. If 10 marks is kept, 10 out of 10, if everything is correct. If you do even at the last step, instead of writing 2 into 3 is 6, if you write 5, you will get 0. Even though you have done all steps correctly, in the last step, while keeping the answer, instead of 2 into 3 is 6, if you keep 5, you will get 0. So, you should be perfect. Mathematics is accuracy also. Correctness and accuracy and speed also. You should write only 6, then only you will get full marks. But board is lenient for you. If you have done few steps, you give marks. There is a scheme of valuation. They will ask you, they will give, ask the teachers, evaluators to give some marks to that. So that is the reason you will get some marks, even if the last step or few steps are wrong. But step wise they give you marks. Otherwise, according to me, either 0 or 100. Either you should get 0 if wrong is there, even if the last step, or everything is correct, 100. So, but I'll tell you, be perfect, be accurate, and try to get full marks. These are the things I have to say about mathematics. And when teacher is doing mathematics, when you are copying the problem, it looks very easy for you, as if you can conquer India. But after 3-4 days, if you reopen the pages and see, you will find the actual difficulty. That should not happen. While after the teacher does it, after you copy it in the paper, you should register here in the brain. That means on the same day, you should go and do it, work it on paper and get it registered in the brain. So mathematics means daily, daily, day-to-day work. You have to do it daily in the brain, and you should get registered in the brain. So never leave the practice. Every day, whatever I do, please go and do it in the house again, then it will be registered. So that is most important thing is mathematics, practice, practice, practice. Okay, and second thing I want to tell you, very important things, of course, this is from apart from academics, and I think you are all from different colleges, and you must have, different schools, you must have scored well also. Don't get carried away by the marks what you have scored in SSLC. Don't get carried away by the marks what you have scored in SSLC 10th standard, because person who got 100 in mathematics in SSLC may get 0 in PUC, and who has got 100 may get 10 in PUC. So please don't get carried away by the marks. Oh, I got 100. Here also I'll easily score 100, 98, 99, nothing like that. No assurance, no guarantee, because here it is entirely different. So far what you have done is some problems they would have done and same problem they would have asked and done. Here, PUC, you are all mature. They will ask you a different type of problems where you have to apply your mind. Here also you need not worry, because if you stick on to our notes, what we give, MGP's notes or Ravana's notes, more than enough, it would have covered all the books. You need not refer any other book. That is more than sufficient to get very good marks, 100 out of 100 sentences in PUC also. Last year also, they have got very good results. This college, I think two have scored sentences, and many have scored more than 95, 96 in this college. 95, 96, 93, it is like this they have scored. So I want you also. I was told that many cream students have come here. So that means you have to get more symptoms. Two symptoms means here you should get 8 to 10, minimum of 10 symptoms here you should get it. Okay, these are small things. Now, I will invite you here. That is, we are not seeing each other because of this COVID. So you stay home, stay safe. I think it is going to open next, most probably the next month. It may start, then we will see, we will have direct contact. And so what I tell you is, small chutuka, nimmellarigu aatmiya swagata, neevu college ge barabeku pratidina neguta neguta. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆತ್ಮೀಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ನೀವು ಕಾಲೇಜಿಗೆ ಬರಬೇಕು ಪ್ರತಿ ದಿನ ನೆಗುತ್ತಾ ನೆಗುತ್ತಾ. ಇಲ್ಲಿನ ನಿಯಮಗಳನ್ನು ಪಾಲಿಸಬೇಕು ನಿತ್ಯ, ಇಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೆ ಗೇಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಸಿಗುವುದಂತೂ ಸತ್ಯ. ಇಲ್ಲಿನ ನಿಯಮಗಳನ್ನು ಪಾಲಿಸಬೇಕು ನೀವು ನಿತ್ಯ, ಇಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೆ ಗೇಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಸಿಗುವುದಂತೂ ಸತ್ಯ. ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಚುಟ್ಕ, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್, ಮೈ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಚುಟ್ಕಾಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಐ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ some other experiences also I will tell you. I was in different posting also, apart from the teaching faculty. I was also in airports also, I will tell you, while classes going on, I'll be telling it. And next important thing is about, the thing you should note is, be sincere and loyal to your work, be true conscious to your work. Second thing is, don't shout at your mother. Mother is God given gift. Because these are the few things, important things I have to tell you in my first class. Always, that is my procedure. So then we shall start. We shall start revising first formula, what all you have studied for first year PUC. But today there will not be any our new class. What I take? I take trigonometry. So I don't teach that. But before that, I give all important formula, both in analytical geometry, or we call it as coordinate geometry, or algebra and trigonometry also will give. In my next classes, we shall start the regular portions. Okay, here what I say is, mother, please respect your mother. Mother is a God-given gift. There is no substitute for mother. You should note, there is no substitute for mother, because mother is a shock absorber. One side she takes all the blame from husband, sometimes shouting also from husband. One side, again, if you also trouble them, children being children, who don't respect and tell them where she should go. So it is a God-given gift, you should note. And you should also, you should know importantly that you must respect her, you should never shout her. Okay, so respect your mother, be obedient to your mother. Mother is a God-given gift, and if mother goes away, there is no substitute. That's the first thing. Second thing about father, again I'll tell you, father's sacrifices are invisible. Because he may have got some this thing from his boss firing, he cannot pass it on to his children, or he has to take care of the children. With he doesn't say anything, any problems, whatever he faces. So it's a sacrifice done by him. Please respect your father also, be obedient to your father. Okay, love your parents. Next is, love your college where you are going to study, love your teachers, love your nation, love your national anthem. All the things you must inculcate in your behavior. You must become first good citizens of India. Okay, the well-behaved citizens of India. So love your teacher. Okay, love your college, love your nation, love your parents. All these are some important things I have to give you. Now we shall start. Now we shall start. So these are the things I wanted to say before my start of lesson. Again, I will tell you, I am M.G. Prasad, okay, mathematics lecturer, and I am also one of the mathematics lecturer. Another mathematics lecturer is Sri Revanna. When he is taking, he will introduce himself. And you have joined a very good college, and I welcome all of you to this college. Now we shall start. Any doubts? And another thing is, don't keep the doubts with you. Any doubts, please get it clarified. What are the doubts are there? You have to get it clarified, and don't keep the doubts with you. This is the one I have to see. Now let us start. However, what I do is, what all you studied in your 10th standard, very important formula, because these formula we use it in our PUC. Many places we use first PUC, second PUC also. So be thorough, and I give all the formula. Apart from it, I will also tell you, these 2 years, please take it very seriously. 2 years you sacrifice all social commitments. So don't go for any, that means not to sit in house itself, not that. What I am telling is, as far as possible, try to avoid all social commitments and your social enjoyments. Okay, allow your parents to go, some marriages are there, if you can avoid it here, because mathematics, if you miss a class, you will lose the track. Again, you will not come back to the track, very difficult. So, please be regular to the classes and allow your parents at the same time to go and enjoy. So, you can stay in the house and you can concentrate on studies as far as possible. If it is inevitable, we cannot help it, because these 2 years, if you sacrifice, then rest of your period you can enjoy. You can join engineering course, whatever the course you desire. Afterwards, you can earn, you know, you can join a very good company, campus interview will be there, then you will become a very good, you will be in the top post, you may be CEO also, we cannot say, you may be managing director, like that, and you can enjoy rest of your life very nicely. So these 2 years, please sacrifice, sacrifice your social commitments and social enjoyments as far as possible. Now, we shall recollect what are the things we have done, because these are the things we write down, important formulae is plural of formula. People say formulas also, that is also correct, formulas they write, but normally the correct expression you can also ascertain with your English teacher, but formula plural is formulae. But even then, some people will write formulas also, no problem. We shall start from the first one. First one is A plus B whole square. We shall start with this right now. I want all this formula to be at one place, because whenever you want, require, you can immediately, if you have forgotten, you can just see. So it should be there on the first page itself, on the your notebook. Keep a notebook for my portion separately, for Revanna's portion separately, and in my this thing, you write down all on the first few pages, all these formulas, very important thing, okay? A plus B whole square is, you can write, remember like this, you know also, A square plus B square plus 2. A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. You can ask me why you are using big letters. You are all small, you are using up to SSLC small letters. Now you are all matured, use big letters. It is one joke I am telling. But better you use it now, big letters. So that I told you, you have come to the college, you are all becoming big and mature. So use big letters. A plus B whole square is A square plus B square plus 2AB. Second one, A minus B whole square is equal to A minus B whole square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So here the difference is plus 2AB. You can ask me, why should you not write A square plus 2AB plus B square? A square minus 2AB plus B square also, definitely you can write it. No problem, A square minus 2AB plus B square, but we remember in this fashion. In college, we remember in this fashion, A plus B whole square, A square plus B square plus 2AB, A minus B whole square, A square plus B square minus 2AB. Third one, A plus B into A minus B. Third one, A plus B into A minus B. A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. Understood? A minus B into A minus B is A square. Or suppose it is ulta also. A square minus B square is there. You can write it in the reverse order. A plus B into wherever the places, some places you may get like this. Then we have to write like this. Some places we have to multiply. Then you have to use like this. I think these are all the formula which you have studied only. What I am giving today is what all you have done, what you have studied only, I am just giving it. In my next class, I will start the regular lessons. Okay, A plus B into A minus B is your A square minus b square. Third, fourth one, you can write out x plus a into x plus b. Who will tell me? X plus a into x plus b, you can write x square plus x into a plus b. X square, x into a plus b plus a. Hold down correctly. X plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus x into a plus b plus a. Next, fifth one, you can say x plus a into x plus b into x plus c. Now, x square plus x into a plus b plus ab. A plus b plus c whole square. A plus b plus c whole square, you can write it a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2c. So a plus b plus c whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2c. Very important formula. Many places we come across this. A plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2c. Okay, next, sixth one, you can write a plus b plus c whole square finished. A square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Now you can write here x plus a into x plus b into x plus c. Three terms are there. X plus a into x. These are why I am giving you all these things is this should be at one place. And we come across many situations where we have to apply this. So if it is on the first page itself, then it will be very easy for you. X plus a into x plus b into x plus c is x cube plus x square into a plus b plus c plus x into ab plus bc plus ca plus abc. So remember correctly, x plus a into x plus b into x plus c is equal to x cube plus x square into a plus b plus c plus x into ab plus bc plus ca plus abc. Very important formula. Many places we use this also. But that means this should be there. Say 2x plus 1 into 2x plus 2 into 2x plus 3. This 2x should be there. Or it can be x plus 3 into x plus 5 into x plus 7. Same thing should be there. So 3x plus 5, 3x plus 2, 3x plus 1, all these things are there. Then we can use this formula. X cube plus x square into a plus b plus c plus x into ab plus bc plus ca plus abc. Seventh one, a plus b whole cube. What is a plus b whole cube? You can remember it this way: a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. You can ask me, why should you not remember like this? A cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. You can remember that way, but we use it in this fashion. In PUC, we use it because problems when it come across, we use this way. That is why remember better in this way. This is if you multiply, you get that 3a square b plus 3ab square. So a plus b whole cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. A cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b is your a plus b whole cube. Yes. You can take next one, eighth one. I am writing here. I suppose all of you can see this. I am just see. Yes. You can write this. A minus b whole cube. A minus b whole cube I am writing. A plus b whole cube finished. Now I am writing a minus b whole cube that is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. All the things like this, all minus only, except here all minus. You should write a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. You can write, or you can also remember this fashion: a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square. Also you can remember a minus b whole cube. Next, ninth one, very important one: a cube plus b cube. What is a cube plus b cube? What is a cube plus b cube? It is nothing but a plus b, important one, a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. So a cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b into this also. Many places, many instances we use this. So it is a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Tenth one is a cube minus b cube. This is also very important. A cube minus b cube is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. Here the difference is plus here, this is minus. Here it is minus, here and it is plus. Okay, it's a very important formula. A cube minus b cube is equal to a cube minus b cube, a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. A cube plus b cube is a plus b into a square minus ab. Okay, a square, a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. Okay, next one. This is another important formula, please take down. A minus b whole square is equal to, this also we make use of many places, a plus b whole square minus 4ab. Write down, a minus b whole square is equal to a plus b whole square minus 4ab. Do that, simplify also, a square plus b square 2ab minus 4ab minus 2ab. That is nothing but a minus b. This is also, we make use of this formula in many places, we should note. Okay. So now we should go to the next formula. These are all, what I am telling you is, why I am giving you all these things are very important. We make use of this formula in different places, in different situations. That is the thing. Now I will rub this. Now we take a minus b whole square over, and now we take another one important thing is there, that is another identity. We can take 12 if a plus, this is very important identity, many places we use, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, who will tell me? Then a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. If a plus b plus c is equal to 0, a very important identity, a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. So please note this, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3. This particular identity, we make use of this identity in many places. You should know, in many places we make use of this identities. See, these are the important formula of algebra what I am giving you, and it is very handy, useful. It should be there on the first few pages on the of my course. Any doubts, you can get it immediately, you can refer also. Now we shall go for indices, theory of indices. Indices means, see, suppose we write a to the power of x, this we call it as base. and this we call it as power or index. Two words are there, power or index. We can call it also as index. So this is base, the down is base, and the power is called index. We can also write it is index, and this we can write it as power. This is power and this is index. Now indices we shall write, some theory of indices we shall write, the important thing. Now 13th one, you write 13th one is a to the power of m, and well, now multiplication na we write dot at the buzzer, it is understood. In BUC you need not write like this, this is nothing but into only. Okay, a to the power of m into a to the power of n is, then bases are same, you can add a to the power of m plus. For example, x square into x to the power of 8, suppose if it is x square into x to the power of 8, it cannot be 16, x to the power of 2 plus 8, x to the power of 10. That means when bases are same, powers can be added, or that index can be added. So a to the power of m into a to the power of n is a to the power of m plus n, x square into 8, x to the power of 2 plus 8, or x to the power of 10. Understood? This is very important. So when the bases are same, you can add the powers. A to the power of m into a to the power of n is a to the power of m plus n. Next, 14th one, a to the power of m by a to the power of n, a to the power of m by a to the power of n is a to the power of m minus n. Suppose x to the power of 7 is there, x cubed is there, then x power 4 at the peripheral hege endre, x power 7 minus 3, or it is x power 4. So it is a to the power of m into a to the power of m by a to the power of n is a to the power of m minus n. That is x to the power of 7 by x cube is x power 7 minus 3, or x to the power of 4. So very important, a power m by a power n is a power m minus n. Next, 15th one. So these are all the things, when power bases are same, you can take it there up and subtract. This you can add it. Next, a to the power of minus m, negative index, and then I bring it to positive index by like this, 1 by a to the power of m. Suppose, say x to the power of minus 3 is there, you can bring it down, write it 1 by x cube. So you can write 1 by x cube. Similarly, in general, a to the power of minus m can be written as 1 by a to the power of m. 16th one is, write down a to the power of minus m is 1 by a to the power of m. In general, if suppose a to the power of minus 1 is there, 1 by a to the power of m, or it is 1 by m. And so a to the power of minus m is 1 by a. Similarly, a to the power of minus 1 in general is 1 by a. Next one. Copy all these things. Again, I will ask you in my next class, you must be in a position to say, I want all these formula to be at one place. Okay. Next one. 17th one, you can take a to the power of 0. Any number raised to the power of 0 is 1. You should note, there is a general form. Any number raised to the power of 0 is 1. Or it is 20 to the power of 0, 1. 1000 to the power of 0, 1. 1 lakh to the power of 0. Any number raised to the power of 0 is 1. Very important. Any number raised to the power of 0, a to the power of 0. I told you 5 to the power of 0, 20 to the power of 0 is 1. Next one, 18th one. A to the power of m to the power of n. This is very important. A to the power of m to the power of n is given by a to the power of mn. That means x square cube is there, multiply, don't write 9, it is x2 into 3 multiply x to the power of 6. Answer is x to the power of 6. You can take it also by the bracket properly. One example, you can take x to the power of 2 to the power of 3 is x to the power of 6. Suppose x to the power of 7 to the power of 2, x to the power of 40. Okay, so what you do is multiply these two, a to the power of m to the power of n is a to the power of m. Next, 19th one, you can take ab to the power of m is a to the power of m and b to the power of m. Suppose xy square is x square y square, xy whole square, xy whole cube, x cube into y cube. So it is a to the power of m and into b to the power of m. 20th is a by b to the power of m is equal to a to the power of m by b to the power of m. A by b whole to the power of m is given by a to the power of m by b to the power of a by b whole to the power of m is given by a to the power of m b to the power of m. Say x by y whole cube is x cube by y cube. X by y whole cube is x cube by y cube. A to the power of m by b to the power of m. X, okay. So these are all the things you should know. Very important thing. A to the power of m into a to the power of m. These are all called theory of indices. That means index. I told you index means power, and your index is power, and the base we call it as it is base. Okay. So these are all the important things you should know. And now you take logarithms. Some logarithms formula I will give you, which are very important logarithms. Because logarithms, of course, I know it was not there for you, but still you copy because there is no earlier days. First year PUC. First year PUC. You had that logarithms. Now it is not there, but these logarithms are very useful in your first PUC physics calculations, physics and chemistry calculations, electrochemistry or whatever it is, physical chemistry or physics calculations, sound, light, and everywhere you can use this formula. Okay, using table, we call it as Clark table. Using Clark table, you will simplify because huge numbers will come. Say some 420,000 something into 3 lakh something like that, you have to multiply. Then you have to use these logarithms. So that is why, but earlier there was a chapter itself, logarithms in mathematics, but now it is not there. But anyway, you can take, I will give you some 5-6 logarithms of this thing, and we make use of it first PUC, second PUC also. So take down first one, here, or you can take 21, okay. 21, log m to the base n plus log m to the base e, log m to the base e plus log m to the base e is given by log, of course this you are not come across, but write down, I will tell you whenever we use it, I will tell you explain this. Log m to the base e, we call it as base e, plus log m to the base e is log m n to the base e. That means e means this, whenever it is to the base e, we call it as Napierian logarithm. We call it as Napierian logarithm, and e value is 2.13, e is a constant, some 2.135 is there. So it is called Napierian. Napierian is a mathematician, we name after him this particular logarithm. Napierian logarithm whenever it is to the base e. Whenever it is to the base 10, it is called common logarithms. Log to the base 10 and the idre, it is common logarithm. That is what you work out in your physics calculation using Clark table. So whenever it is to the same base, log m to the base e is log m n to the base e. Next one you can take log m to the base e minus log m to the base e is equal to log m by n to the base e. We call it as log m to the base e minus log n to the base e is log m by n to the base e. Okay, 23rd one you can take log m to the base n, sorry, to the base e, log m to the power of n to the base e, then this will come by the side of it, n log m to the base e. Log m to the power of n to the base e is n log, this will come by the side, n log m to the n log m to the base, I think you are able to see, yes, log, yes, log m to the power of n to the base e is n log m to the base e. Now 24th one, log e to the base e, something like a to the power of 0, it is actually 1. Okay, log e to the base e is 1, something like a to the power of 0, it is 1. Okay, log e to the power of e base e is 1. So log e to the base e is 1. 25th one, very important one, we call it as change of base root. That is, if you want to change the base, log m to the base n is, if you want to change to the base e, what you should do is, this also very important, many places we use, log n to the base e. Suppose you are changing this base n to base e, log m to the power of, you say m to the base n is, want to change this base to e, then log m to the base e by log m to the base. So these are all the very important things in logarithms also. We make use of these things in our first usage, second usage also. Apart from that, we use it in physics calculations. I said a very important thing, physics calculations also. Very important thing. Okay. Oh, apart from this, you know, I think you had some, I read this, you have taken. So take it, keep it at one place. Now there is arithmetic progression, I think you must have studied. Arithmetic progression here. What are the arithmetic progressions? Is a, a plus d, a plus 2d, this is called ab. We call it as arithmetic progression. Ab and the variety. This is arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression. I think you must have studied series. Only idmatra irbeku gp illa anta kalisutte nimge gp which you are going to learn this year. Anyway, it is all right. A plus d, a plus 2d, like this. Nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d, where you can take down a is the first term, d is common difference, d is common difference, a is the first term, d is the common difference, n is number of terms. N is number of terms. So a is the first term, d is common difference, and n is number of terms. So nth term is given by nth term of an ap. Nth term of an ap, ap is the arithmetic progression of an ap, is given by tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is the first term, nth term of an ap, is given by the formula Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. And sum to n terms is given by sum to n terms of ap. Sum to n terms of ap is given by Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This is your sum to n terms of an ap. N by 2 to 2a plus n minus 1 into d. N term is a plus n minus 1 into d. See, suppose it is like this. 5, 7, 9, 11. You have to find out some 20th term or so. So what you should do is, a is 5. Common difference can be obtained by subtracting from the subsequent 9 minus 7, 11 minus 5, like that. D is 2, then n is 20 term, then you substitute in this, you will get the 20th term. This is the, I think this you must have done it in your SSLC class, I feel so. So anyway, if it is not done, please take it. And anyway, this year also it is there, continuation of AP is there, GP also there, then HP is not there for you, arithmetic mean is there, geometric mean is there, that we are going to take up later. So these are all the things, nth term of AP. Now you take some quadratic equation, I write the roots. Now what that the quadratic equation says is, yes, now your quadratic equation says, if ax square, next one you take some next point, is any point in the body, if ax square plus bx plus c, any equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then roots are, then roots, roots means value of x. If it has got 2, degree is 2, you have got 2 roots. If degree is 3, 3 roots, degree is 4, 4 roots. If degree is n, you will have n degree, yeah, that is n roots, n number of roots of equation. Now ax square plus 2x plus c is equal to 0, then roots are, n root in beko, one is x equal to minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac. You also know, I think, this you have done how to, we also called polynomial zeros. It is also called, whenever it is root, we also call it as polynomial zeros of roots. We have already done. Find the polynomials of zeros also, they have asked in examination, you must have done it also. So, x equal to minus b plus r plus square root of b square plus 4ac. Another one is minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2. So, one is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac. Another one minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2. One is plus, another one is minus. This is, we also call it as this root as alpha, this root as beta. We write the first root as plus, minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is alpha, we call it as minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac. We call it as beta. By 2a, we call it as beta. Now, actually sum of roots, you should also note, sum of roots is alpha plus beta is, or m and n3, m plus n is given by minus b by a, and product of roots, you can take down, product of roots is given by alpha beta is equal to c by a. So, this is sum of roots and this is product of roots. So, sum of roots is minus b by a, and product of roots alpha beta is given by c by a. Sum of roots is given by minus b by a. So, you should also know this. This is called quadratic equation. Suppose 3 is a cubic equation. Ax to the power of 4 is a biquadratic equation. We call it as biquadratic equation. So, if it has got 4 roots, it is 2 roots. So, it has got 2 roots. 2 roots is given by this. You know, in general, plus or minus. But 2 roots we are writing separately. And sum of roots is given by minus b by a. And product of roots is given by c by a. Now we should take, yes, we will take analytical geometry. Analytical geometry, it is nothing but coordinate geometry. What is coordinate geometry? It is a branch of mathematics which deals with the study of coordinates. Coordinates are x coordinate, y coordinate, and you know 4 quadrants also. 4 quadrants, how the coordinates behave, you know, plus plus, minus plus, minus minus, and plus minus. So, 4 quadrants are there. Actually, in analytical geometry, few things you should learn. Now, one is, I think, coordinate geometry. First one you can take down. Analytical, we call it as analytical geometry. That is nothing but coordinate geometry. Coordinate geometry, the distance between, write down, the distance between B bar W already, between, distance between 2 points, the distance between 2 points P, X1, Y1, first represents always X coordinate, and Q, X2, Y2, the distance between the 2 points P, X1, Y1, and Q, X2, Y2 is given by, say like this, is the distance, P is x1, y1, and q is x2, y2 is given by the formula pq is equal to this distance. Is anybody knows that pq is given by square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1. And distance is always scalar, it should be plus 1. Okay. So, PQ is, what is scalar, vector, I will tell you later. Distance, length, everything is called scalar. Displacement is vector, which you are going to study later. There is a separate chapter itself, vectors. Okay. The distance between the two points, P, dq is square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is also called distance formula. We call it as is also called distance formula. Distance between P and Q, it's called distance formula. You should note this is called distance. We are not touching trigonometry. Trigonometry we are going to touch in the next class. And we'll revise it, what all you are studying, then we'll go to our syllabus. Now, second one is section formula. The points P and Q, P x1 y1 and Q x2 y2, the point on which divides a line joining the points P x1 y1 and Q x2 y2 internally, very important, underline that, internally in the ratio m is to n, is given by, that means the coordinates of R. That is, coordinates of R is given by coordinate x over here, that is given by this formula mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, then comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Andre hege andre, see, take out this one also, p ide, x1 y1, 2 ide, x2 comma y2 ide, okay, and this is the one R and that coding, R divides m in n, R is inside PQ, we call it as internally, we write it as R, which divides P and Q internally in the ratio m, that is PR by RQ is m by n, adre e coordinates n ide andre, idu this one, mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n. Suppose externally in the R ill birth, idu m, idu n, that is internally is given by mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n, and suppose R divides externally, this also you should note, R divides externally, this will be minus r, mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, comma my2 minus ny1 by m minus n, mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. When it is external andre r illirutte, idu olagade irutte, r olagade idre it is internally and it is externally, then there is midpoint anta vandide. We will take up next time. I will write that formula. Midpoint, suppose if it is same adre, m n eradu adre midpoint anta hogutte, other coordinates eno, I think you must have already learnt. Then again, apart from that, midpoints, you have got the centroid of a triangle, coordinates of centroid of a triangle eno, anantra area of a triangle, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3 adre, then what is that area of the triangle also we should know. So these are the things which you are going to take up next class. The Barbuddini Anantra we shall take up our chapter trigonometry, and I do recollect what all you are studying in trigonometry, and then we will go to our syllabus. Okay, thank you very much, and you must first by heart all the things whatever I have given. In my next class, if I ask, you must be in a position to say, you should register more than a paper, you should register here. I told you the same day you write it, register in your brain. Thank you all. Okay.